Hi, I'm Mrs. Charles with iSpy Science and Wired for Science. The name of today's video is Singing Glasses. I'm going to show you two science experiments about sound that you can do at home using your own supplies. Okay, these are the materials that you need for both experiment A and experiment B. You need 5 glasses. They all have to be the same size and style. You need water, you need vinegar, you need paper towels for cleanup, a spoon, and food coloring is optional. You don't really need to use it, but I do because it'll help you see the water levels in the glasses better. Okay, now I'm going to show you what we're going to do for singing glasses part A. You line up your glasses in a row and fill them with different amounts of water. There's one. And each time you pour, it's going to get a little higher. Okay, if you're using food coloring, you'll want to stir it first. I've already done it to all 5 of my glasses, and you can see the different levels in each glass of water. Now use your spoon to tap on the glass. Listen to the sounds made on each glass. Okay, so what's happening? You'll notice that the more water in the glass makes a lower sound. Less water in the glass makes a higher pitch or a higher sound. Tapping on the glass with a spoon causes particles of the jar to vibrate. The vibrations in the jar go into the air as a sound wave, which is what you hear. In the glass with a lot of water, the vibrations are slower and have a lower sound. Less water allows the glass particles to vibrate more easily and faster, so they make a higher sound. Now I'm going to show you what to do for singing glasses part B. You use the same glasses that you did. This experiment will not work with all glasses. You might have to try a couple different kinds of glasses. Real crystal works best, but I found that if I was patient and practiced that I could do this with my regular drinking glasses. And what you first need to do is wash your fingers in a little vinegar. I've got vinegar in this, so wash my fingers, dry them on a paper towel so your fingers are really clean. Dip your finger into the water and make slow circles around the rim of each glass. So what's happening here? As you rub your finger around the rim of the glass, at first your finger sticks to the glass and then it slides. This friction creates vibrations inside the glass. The vibrations make sound waves that you hear as one clear tone. Like the part A experiment when we used the spoons, did you notice that the smaller amount of water in the glass makes a higher sound than the one with the larger amount of water in it? You can experiment at home. When you use the spoons to make sounds, can you figure out how to make a simple song or tune? When you rub your finger around the glass rim, can you make the sound louder or softer by how hard or how fast you press your finger? So, I wish you good luck when you try these science experiments. I hope you can make beautiful sounds or beautiful music and have fun doing it.